Yung sa OPM na legit, yung parang pinaka OPM lang talaga na 100%. Parang kumbaga nandun yung emotions eh. 'Di ba? Pag sinabi mong OPM ay emotions, kasi pipa parang medyo party ganun.
My inbox has been blowing up with reaction requests about this interview with an OPM artist that I barely know. Fans said that he had interesting things to say about P-pop music, and I'm here for it. So I guess it's another my opinion to his opinion type of video. Without further ado, let's get into it. So it started with the interviewer saying how P-pop right now has been on the rise, and then asked an artist an interesting question.
Balik tayo dun kanina sa usapan na ba? Like last night kasi, ang daming paramdam ng P-pop. It's really on the rise. What are your thoughts about P-pop?
P-pop?
Like even Warner has its own, ano? Diba? A boy group.
Siguro po for me, is for me po kasi, hindi naman sa lahat, hindi naman lahat ng ano. Parang kumbaga kasi, yung P-pop tsaka parang P-pop parang nakuha nila sa K-pop eh.
Right off the bat, his vibe for me is that he doesn't really know a lot about the music industry. He doesn't even know that K-pop borrowed a lot from J-pop and the West.
So bas maganda po siguro kung gagawa yung hindi ko pa sinasabi na ano ha, hindi lahat ng group. Parang siguro po for me magandang may parang ano sila may uniqueness na kware kung K-pop, diba, yung K-pop may parang unique style sila.
What? K-pop is not unique at all. In fact, nowadays they sample a lot of their music from popular music overseas. Here are some examples. I'm on the next level, yeah, I know you heard about it. I'm on the next level, yeah, 절대적 rule을 지켜. This is one by one, even two by two. Everybody in the floor, let me show you how we do. By one and two by two, 내 손끝 툭 하나에 다 무너지는 중. You got me begging you for mercy. Why won't you release? 마음을 사로잡는 dancing. Yeah, yeah. 그 화려한 소리. Got the people saying, Brooklyn saying, la 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 la. Everybody say la 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 la. Say la 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 la. You guys get what I mean, right? P-pop groups don't even do that.
So siguro sa Philippines maganda if yung mga P-pop band or artist may parang unique way din sila kung paano mo i-ano na ay ito Philippines to. Ganun.
That's exactly what SB19 is doing today.
SB19, yeah. Performing tomorrow at the Palladium, and I know you make the Philippines proud, but you make all of us proud.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations. Nice to have you.
Thank you so much.
Did you hear the reporter? She herself acknowledges that SB19's music represents the Philippines, and she's even proud of them. I mean, look at this. You don't see these words often on a US live TV. Going back, I can sense that the reporter was kind of saddened by this guy's answers, and you can hear it in his voice when he asked this follow-up question.
Nakikinig ka ba?
Hindi po ako mahilig sa
kahit mga SB19. Not even. Or even yung, ano nga yung sa Warner? Vixen ba yung sa Warner yata? You don't know?
Hindi.
Okay, pero yung style mo, ano ha? Medyo shoot sa style ng kumi K-pop. Yeah, kumi P-pop.
Oo, yung ano, tawag doon. Siguro po medyo.
I actually agree. His getup right now, especially his tattoos, remind me a lot of Ken's fashion.
Pero siguro mag-stick pa din po ako doon sa parang ano talaga. Kumbaga yung, andun pa din yung pagka-OPM. Yung parang pagka-traditional ng OPM, di ba? Parang
Yung pagka-traditional. Oo, kasi people would argue, OPM pa din naman to. It's the OPM naman to.
Oo.
Pero ang gusto mo yung, ano ba yung traditional na
parang
OPM para sa'yo?
Yung parang may signatures, ano kasi, parang way kung paano mo i-ano yung OPM. Like, Siguro kasi P-pop, like 'di ba sa P-pop parang more on sounds na siya. Ganon. Tapos OPM naman, yung sa OPM na legit, yung parang pinaka OPM lang talaga na 100%. Parang kumbaga nandun yung emotions eh. 'Di ba? Pag sinabi mong OPM ay emotions, tapos kasi P-pop parang medyo party ganon.
What? That is arguably one of the most ridiculous opinions I heard about P-pop. Yes, we have party songs like Wyatt, but when it comes to emotion, MAPA hanggang sa huli ang Tila Luha are looking at you, bro. Even in the 90s, we already have P-pop groups that do that, like Jeremiah. Hindi na sana, hindi na sana iniwan pa.
Sana'y patawarin na. Siguro kung may band or artist na na P-pop na ganun, siguro ma-encourage niya ako makinig sa kanya na sa ganun.
I'm telling you guys, once he starts listening to slower P-pop songs, he might easily become a fan. The obvious thing really going on in here is just his lack of knowledge when it comes to music.
Okay. What is your, my last question on this subject? What is your message to the P-pop groups? Like as I mentioned, Beanie ay P-pop, ano? Beanie, BGY, o yung sa Warner, no, Vixen yata yun.
Ayun,
kasi di ba parang ang out nila is World Domination. No? So what's your message to them?
Ayun, so ano, syempre ano, happy din ako na syempre na di-discover yung ano natin, ang tawag dito, yung P-pop music natin is parang nagiging K-pop na siya, kumbaga, di ba?
Now, a lot of people might have misunderstood that statement. But I think all he was saying there was about P-pop's rise in popularity having a trajectory similar to how K-pop started, which is a good thing.
Kasi may mga international na listeners na din na nakikinig kahit di nila naintindihan.
Oo.
So, sobrang happy ako dun.
At saka SB19 nag-billboard.
Oo, grabe nga eh.
His body language and the way he reacted gives away the possibility that he just found out the moment he heard from this reporter. Let's have a second look.
Sobrang happy ako dun.
At saka SB19 nag-billboard.
Oo, grabe nga eh.
Billboard.
Oo.
Right?
Ayun, sobrang happy ako and ipagpatuloy lang nila yung ganun. And siguro, improvements pa na wag nilang kakalimutan na pag sinabing T-pop, dapat andun yung, kumbaga, nakatatak pa din yung Philippines, ganun.
Yo, P-pop is from the Philippines. It stands for Pinoy Pop, dude.
Hindi lang, siguro kung hindi sa lyrics, sa sound, parang ganun.
Sound? I think you should listen to Alamat. How about some SB19?
Thanks, Arthur.
Okay, so that's the end of the interview. This video made me want to check his channel, and I found out that Arthur Miguel is actually a very talented Filipino artist. He has a massive following, pushing to almost 1 million subscribers. He has different song covers that amasses millions of views, like this one. I was enchanted to meet you. He even has a single called Pasahili, which means para sa hindi pinili. Talk about how SB19 titled their debut single. Anyway, I made this video not to hate on the guy, but to raise awareness about what P-pop really is, because sadly, a lot of people still don't understand it. P-pop is OPM, and it's clearly opposite to what Arthur thinks. P-pop is not trying to be something that already exists. P-pop is P-pop, because a wise man once said,
I guess the authenticity, when you're doing something that you really love, it transcends to them. And everyone's just trying to achieve their dreams. No matter big or small the stage is, you should never regret what you're doing.